Hi, this is Alfauzia Nihar from At Home Tuition. Welcome to our session today. The topic that we are going to discuss in our today's video is power rule. In this video, let us see how to differentiate functions of the form y equal to ax raised to n. This will identify the various forms that these functions take, and I'm going to introduce the power rule of differentiation to find their derivatives. Many functions take the form y is equal to ax raised to n, where n is the power of the variable x and a is called the coefficient of x. Functions of this type are usually the first that you learn to differentiate. They cover a wide range of mathematics that you may have already come across. Specifically, they describe straight lines, polynomials such as quadratic and cubic functions, reciprocals and roots. Okay, it depends upon the value of n. If n is equal to 0, this equation will just become a constant one. Am I right? If n is equal to 1, it will become a straight line. If n is a positive whole number greater than 1, you will be getting a quadratic equation, a cubic equation and so on. In case if n is a negative whole number, then you will be getting a reciprocal, because if you have a negative exponent, you have to shift it to the denominator to make it a positive integer. Am I right? I mean positive exponent. Okay. If n is a fraction, then you will get an equation with square root. For example, if n is equal to 1 over 2, x raised to 1 over 2 is nothing but square root of x. Am I right? These functions can be differentiated by the power rule of differentiation, which is usually the first major rule you will be encountering when learning calculus. So what is meant by differentiation? Differentiation can help you understand the terminology of the calculus. The power rule is a two-part formula for finding the derivatives of a function of the form y equal to ax raised to n. If y is equal to ax raised to n, then the derivative, what would be the formula? Dy over dx, dy or x raised to n will be n times x raised to n minus 1. I'll apply the same rule for this one with a coefficient a. You just have to multiply the coefficient a with the exponent n here. So a times n x raised to n minus 1, where n is the power of x and a is the coefficient. To use the power rule successfully, you need to become comfortable with how these two parts interact. So to begin with, you must be able to identify those functions which can be differentiated using this rule, power rule. This rule depends on you being able to identify the values of a and n from the first part of the rule and substituting them correctly into the second part. So it may be necessary for you to manipulate a function to see that it fits the pattern y equal to a times x raised to n. First you have to check this function is matching your question. As differentiation naturally follows on from algebra in mathematical studies, you need to be comfortable with the many skills and techniques involved in algebra to help you with the processes and concepts of differentiation. A good understanding of the law of indices and rules of arithmetic involving fractions are essential. Already in our video of differentiation rule basics, I would have mentioned this problem. You should be familiar with the processes and concepts of differentiation. You should be familiar with all the rules of arithmetic. Okay. So next we can see the examples of variety of functions which can be differentiated using the power rule. So let's see how to use the power rule in examples. So in the examples, we will cover a variety of different cases for a and n, and are chosen to highlight some common difficulties we used to face when we are using power rule. First case is horizontal lines. When n is equal to 0, if the exponent is equal to 0, the term itself will become 1. So a times 1 is a itself. So if you get a function like this, y equal to a constant, then this will represent a horizontal line if you are going to graph it. This function does not look like y equal to a times x raised to n at the moment, and so you may think that you cannot use the power rule to differentiate it. However, the law of indices tells that you x raised to 0 is equal to 1, no? So a times 1 is a. Replacing 1 with x raised to 0 will give you y equal to a x raised to 0. So where the dot implies multiplication in between this. Okay. If you're thinking about the graph that the equation represents, you may gain some insight into its derivative. Please remember that the gradient of the graph is given by the derivative and by the change in y divided by change in x. Am I right? That's the slope. So for a horizontal line, the change in y is 0 obviously. So the gradient of the horizontal line is 0. So this is an important result that is reflected in the fact that derivative of a constant is 0. Okay. Let me take one example for this type of equation. Differentiate y equal to 2. I'm replacing a by 2. As y equal to 2 is a horizontal line, you already know that its gradient is 0. So if you can correctly identify a and n in the first part of the power rule, you can use the second part to differentiate the function. So it may help to write the first part of the power rule and another function to help you see a and n. So using the law of indices, you can rewrite this equation into an exponent form. So y equal to 2 times x raised to 0. Am I right? So in the place of a we have 2 and in the place of n we have 0. So remember that n is the power of x and a is the coefficient of x. For horizontal graphs, a is always the constant in the function. As you know a and n, you can use the second part of the power rule to find the derivative. I'm just going to apply the formula here. By applying the formula, keep the constant here. N 0, x 0 minus 1 is minus 1. 0 times any term is 0 itself. So, the product will result in 0. So, y equal to 2 has a gradient of 0. Hope you are clear with this case horizontal lines. This will be applicable for any constant. First, you have to rewrite this in this format and identify what is a and n and then apply the formula for differentiation. And you can understand that the gradient of y equal to any constant the graph of y equal to any constant has a gradient of 0. Hope you are clear with this case. Okay, next we can discuss straight lines of the form y equal to a times x. So far we discussed a constant. Now let's take a variable. Straight lines of the form y equal to ax. Functions of this form y equal to a times x raised to n with n equal to 1 can be written as y equal to ax. These functions represent straight lines with gradient a which passes through the origin. Am I right? Okay. As the gradient of any line is given by its derivative, derivative of y equal to ax must be equal to a. So, intuitively, the value of a in the function of this type should give the same result as the power rule of differentiation. I'll explain you the same concept with an example. Can we replace a by a negative number? Okay. Here is the example. As y equal to negative 7x is a straight line through the origin, you can refer this graph. Its gradient is given by the coefficient of x, which is nothing but negative 7. You can use the law of indices to rewrite y equal to negative 7x as an exponent form. I'm going to x raised to nothing is nothing but x raised to 1. Am I right? X and x raised to 1 both are same. So if you compare this with the original form, you can understand that in the place of a we have negative 7 and in the place of n we have 1. So a is negative 7, n is 1. As your function fits the pattern for the first part of the power rule, you can use the second part to find the derivative. Okay, let's apply the rule. So x raised to 1 minus 1, x raised to 0, so which is nothing but 1. So negative 7 times 1 times 1 is negative 7. So y equal to negative 7x has a derivative of negative 7, which is the same as the expected gradient. A useful method to use to find a in the power rule is to cover up x and its power. What remains is the value of a. For example, in y equal to negative 7x, if you cover up the x, you have negative 7 remaining. Am I right? Which is the correct value of a? Let me take one more example. Instead of negative 7, I'm going to take one fraction there. Here is an example, y equal to x over 3. So when you just look at this equation, it is not as easy to identify a in this example. A common error is to say a is 3. However, you should be careful when your function is a fraction. By using your knowledge of how fractions multiply together, x over 3 can be written as 1 over 3 times x. Am I right? So as well as the law of indices, you can rewrite the function as 1 over 3 times x or x over 1. Both the same, no? Any number divided by 1 is nothing but the term itself. X is nothing but x raised to 1. So this gives us, in the place of a we have 1 over 3 and in the place of n we have 1. So you can use these values in the second part of the power rule. So let's apply the formula. Let's see what we are going to get. So if you are applying the power rule here, 1 times x raised to 1 minus 1. 1 minus 1 is 0, x raised to 0 is obviously 1. So multiplying 1 over 3, you'll be getting 1 over 3. So the function is a straight line with a gradient 1 over 3, which passes through the origin. Okay, let me show the graph for this function also. Hope you are clear with this example. So to solve any differentiation problem, you should be familiar with multiplying and dividing fractions, cancelling down fractions, multiplying and dividing algebraic fractions, law of indices, and also you should have some knowledge about the functions and how to use the functions. Okay. So far we have discussed two cases. In our upcoming video, let's discuss the leftover cases. Hope you are clear with the concept that we discussed in this video. In case if you have any query regarding the application of power rule, kindly let me know. See you in the next video. Have a great time.